What do you make of the fallout now from the president's decision to fire Secretary Nielsen?
Well, it was long overdue. It was time for her to go. I've been calling for her to resign since last June after she was misleading the public about the separation of families. But here's the reality is there's chaos in the Department of Homeland Security. There's nobody really in charge there. The number one person is now gone. The number three person left. Vitello got pulled. We don't know who's in charge, frankly. It's disorganized, and you can see that happening at the border. I was just in El Paso this weekend to see firsthand the accounts of the way our migrants are being treated, and it's completely inhumane.
So in terms of the reporting from our colleagues as well as from other outlets with the ascent of Stephen Miller to having a more prominent voice on the issue of immigration within the administration, what does that mean from your committee's vantage point in terms of more oversight over DHS?
Well, it's deeply alarming and concerning that this president and Stephen Miller want to be tougher on immigration and tougher at the border. We're going to have serious oversight and continue it probably more closely than ever, especially when you hear reports of the president and the administration wanting to go back to zero tolerance policy, wanting to go back to the separation, and whether Stephen Miller is behind that is pretty outrageous. But the American people need to do what they did last time, and that is be outraged, speak up, so that we can make sure that it is not happening again and these policies are not reinstated. I can assure you that the chairman of our committee and our committee will be on top of this administration to make sure that we know what is happening and how they're implementing policy. And frankly, we need to look at funding opportunities where if we need to put in restrictions so they treat people humanely and not doing what they want to do again, which is separating families. We should look at those options as well.
Congresswoman Barragan, I was wondering, what are you hearing from your home state in California, which is so dependent on agriculture and migrant workers? Are they having a real issue with the administration's immigration policy?
I think a lot of people are having real issues with this administration's policy. Certainly, my congressional district is heavily impacted by the administration's immigration policies. I have a district that's 70% Latino. When you go down to the south border, we certainly see agricultural workers down there and the conditions that they face. And we are hearing from folks about the impacts this is going to have overall on the workforce in California. That's something I'd have to talk to more to my colleague Juan Vargas about, who represents the southern border down in San Diego.
And, you know, besides basically trying to make sure this doesn't happen again, is there anything that you think the administration can and should do immediately to relieve what's happening on the border?
Well, I think the first thing they immediately need to do is to get humanitarian aid that Congress allocated in February. We gave $415 million for humanitarian relief at the border. That money needs to immediately get there so they can use that dollars to treat people right. I mean, it's unconscionable what's happening there. You've got four-month, five-month-old children sleeping under the elements outside in the cold with the same clothes for 5 days, and they're dirty. They're bound to get sick. It's not healthy. So we need to immediately address that issue. Second, we need to look at other options to detention. This has been something the prior administration had done. This current administration would love to get rid of Flores. It would love to hold children indefinitely with family units. We know that. We heard some of the White House advisors talk about that. We also heard it straight from CBP at the border this weekend. They want to get they want to do away with this decision, which was actually put in place to protect children and to not have them detained indefinitely because of the trauma it causes them.
Congresswoman, from an economic standpoint, the president last week threatening to raise tariffs on 25% of autos coming from Mexico should they not get to the negotiating table in terms of taking a more hardline approach. The administration argues on the issue of immigration. But from an economic standpoint, $1.7 billion in commerce daily crossing the U.S.-Mexico border. What would the economic impacts be to the U.S. economy should the president raise tariffs or shut down ports of entry or stops along the border?
Well, it would be a disaster. That's the short way to put it. Because of the trade that we do with Mexico, shutting down that border would be a disaster, not to just the American economy, to American workers. This weekend in Texas, we actually spoke to business officials and business owners who are both on the Mexico side and the U.S. side, talking about the long lines and the slowdown that's happening right now with the ports of entry and how that could cause plants to shut down on both sides. It's unbelievable and unreal that the president would want to inflict economic damage on this country and on American businesses. So we really urge him to reconsider that option. And businesses along the border are doing the same thing.